This week on Maker Update, a nightstand with a special touch, a flip dot display for your Spotify playlist, an election countdown clock, and a brushless motor business card. Hey everybody, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. I'm coming to you again from the TMDC workshop in Barcelona. I hope you're all doing well. Let's get started with the project of the week. When was the last time you appreciated your nightstand? You'll spend half your life sleeping next to one, but it's probably the most generic piece of furniture in your home. On the Make with Miles channel, Miles sets out to create a thoroughly unique nightstand customized for his bedtime reading ritual. Now, sometimes I'll highlight a project here because of a technical innovation or the project's novelty or scale, and there's certainly a lot of skill and technique on display here, resulting in a nightstand unlike any I've seen before. You're going to learn about kerf bending and molding plywood into organic shapes. You'll learn about edge banding and veneers and flush trimming with a router. But what really sticks with me about this project video is the storytelling. Give this video a watch and I promise you that you'll care more about Miles finishing this nightstand than you've ever cared about a nightstand before. Setbacks, mistakes, freezing winters, missed deadlines, it all contributes to an inspiring story of perseverance. Miles just also has a really watchable and entertaining editing style that makes you appreciate the video craft here as much as the project itself. And if you're writing this one off for not being electrical or mechanical, think again. There's a potentiometer wired into this table. It connects up to a custom lamp that runs on a track and pulley system that we're told we'll see more of in an upcoming video. So check it out. More projects. On flipdisc.io, Kathy Korevec has a fantastic guide and video on how she made this 84 by 42 pixel flip dot display. It's an advanced guide that involves custom PCBs, plenty of wiring, a custom frame of 8020 aluminum extrusion, and software running on an NVIDIA Jetson Orin Nano single board computer. But for all of that effort, you get a showpiece worthy high frame rate display on par with the systems I've seen from Breakfast Studios. There's also a bunch of fun and practical features Kathy's developed to run on the display. There's a New York Times RSS reader, a Spotify client, a weather app, a clock, and even a cellular automata script. It also looks like she's interested in finding collaborators for developing new Flipdisc hardware, so if this is your kind of thing, be sure to reach out. On Hackaday, a guide from CriptasticHacker and Ruth Grace Wong on how they made this giant election countdown timer sign. This project has been in the works since July of last year. Because it's mounted outside, there were a lot of considerations around materials, weatherproofing, and outdoor durability. Not to say that it's perfect, there are plenty of Tupperware enclosures and hot glue, but the project crossed the finish line. Inside, there's a Node MCU ESP32 Wemos board driving 9 7-segment displays made from addressable LED strip. I imagine the acrylic is the most expensive part of this whole project. Also on Hackaday, a detailed look from Andy Geppert on this business card-sized brushless motor and driver kit. You heard that right, he's built a functioning brushless motor that fits into the circuit board that's used to drive it. A schematic printed on the board illustrates how the circuit works. From winding your own stator coils to 3D printing your own motor, the kit helps you explore all the features we take for granted in modern brushless motor systems. Now for some tips and tools. Through the Adafruit blog, I learned about the M5 Stack ESP32 Smart Dial. This is a capacitive touchscreen, rotary encoder, and ESP32 board all in one package that runs around $35. It lends itself to smart home applications, but really, I could see this being popped into all sorts of projects. I hadn't seen anything quite like it before, and you can pick one up on DigiKey. On Instructables, Josh Charles shares how he created his own mini sheet metal brake using inexpensive hinges and angle iron. The real trick to this one seems to be getting the tolerances and positioning just right so that your bends are consistent. If you're making lots of 90-degree bends in smaller material, this could really be a useful tool to have attached to your workbench. On his channel, Jeremy Fielding dives into the more esoteric, more expensive, and to me, more fascinating types of industrial and robotic gears. Starting with large, high-torque worm gears, then planetary gears, and finally harmonic drives or strain wave gears, not only do we get to peek inside the inner workings of how these gears work, but Jeremy provides a useful list of considerations for each type, weighing the trade-offs. Worth a watch, you'll definitely get an appreciation for the engineering that goes into these. And finally, on the Slant 3D channel, a surprising list of options for creating 3D printable designs without using CAD software. I won't reveal all the options here, but the idea is that there are a number of free online web tools for making lithophanes, topographical maps, figurines, or customizing parametric designs. Of course, learning a CAD tool of some kind is going to open up a whole other world of options for you, but if you're not there yet and you found yourself with a 3D printer, you can still have some fun making customized designs. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, over on the DigiKey Product Discovery channel, there's an unboxing of the DKS TK1 Standard Toolkit. This is DigiKey's own toolkit aimed at students and hobbyists who need a handy kit with all the essentials for working with electronics, soldering iron, multimeter, pliers, strippers, drivers, and a whole lot more, all thoughtfully organized in a custom molded clamshell box priced around $100. Makes a great gift for someone getting started, or maybe this is something you keep in your car or at work for working on electronics away from home. Check it out. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks to TMDC Workshop. Thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible. And thank you for watching. I'll see you again soon.